Okay, it's June 27th, 2019. Mr. Thomas came out here with his pickup truck and the chain and got these big branches off the yard. 86-year-old man with a pickup truck and a chain. And I'm left with a little bit of an aftermath to clean up. Now, I want to show you, this is who suffers from this weather out here. I can have to handle it. There's nothing I can do about it. But you know, our hummingbirds out here, see that one down there? It's injured. I just put that feeder down there, went in to get a camera. When I put there, he stuck his beak in and started feeding a little bit. All I was using was this branch here, trying to get him on the branch. I don't know where to put him. You're not supposed to touch these, you're not supposed to keep them. You're not supposed to keep them in captivity. They can't fly. That's from the branches out here that flew off over here. It flew on the feeders and whatnot. He was down in the ground over here. And I just put this feeder by him, hoping that he, because he's got that red neck. He's a ruby-throated hummingbird. So, trying to get him to feed. I can't make him. I don't know if he'll be able to get to some. Go on and get some. Smallest little thing there is out here in nature. Something like a hummingbird. So you see my hand next to him. My index finger is longer than he is. Oh God, he was right on the feeder earlier, trying to eat. Now he keeps flopping around because he's losing his energy. I'm sorry, I'm not trying to hurt you. I'm trying to get you where you can eat. I picked up one branch that got stung right on my finger. Right where that red spot is there. I started sucking the venom out of it right away. I kept sucking it so it didn't burn for about 30, 40 seconds. I didn't panic or anything. I felt it when I was moving the branch. I was picking up one of the ladders by the swimming pool, and when I did that, it stung me. So, if you ever get stung, and you can, just, like I say, start sucking the venom out right away, and, you know, get the sting right if you can. I figured that was just the easiest thing to do, and I'm going to put peroxide on it, put some alcohol on it when I go in the house. I think this little guy is probably going to die. Nothing I can do. I'm trying not to touch him. I'm using leaves and everything else to coax him to feed and such, but you know, I don't want to hurt him. Come on, okay. I know you want to fly. Oh, shoot. So he gets on here like a perch, and then he tries to fly off of it and falls down again. See, like that. Right here. Eat. See, he's probably gonna die. I'm gonna leave the feeder on the ground here with him. It's I don't know what time it is either. It's around 8:30. If you have land, you control the land. When you don't, you're at the whims of everybody else. And don't forget that. That's why I get so aggravated out here. I can't really do anything. I can make small adjustments to it, and that's it. But I don't have the money or the equipment to do what I want to do. The landlord comes out here, he picks the big branches up. There's a couple up there I got to take over to the ditch somehow tomorrow, or today maybe. One down in the ditch I'm not going to be able to get. But that hummingbird's going to stay out here and probably die. It's nature, I guess you call it. You're not supposed to touch them and handle them, which I made the mistake of doing that once before. But yeah, he's breathing so hard, I'm trying to get him to eat. There. Now, I don't know if they don't have a sense of that or what. See, he's trying to fly. He keeps getting to a point where he wants to fly. But his beak is right over the food, right above it. That's it, don't focus. Oh yeah, it's a Sony. Piece of shit Sony. Looks like he'd be feeding, but he's not. His beak is just right over it, the feeders. 16 feeders on there, 16 slots. And he's gonna die just with his beak right across. He did the first time, like I said, when I put down there, he put his beak right in it and started feeding him. Now he's not doing anything. Oh, see, I moved the cane close to him. I'm sorry this happened to you. Call it climate control or whatever the other stupid people want to call it. I'd say they messed up the jet stream, which is factual. Not something made up that's going to charge people more money for things that they don't need. It's called control. So, and as a direct result, you're going to die because, you know, yeah.
The Republicans, they want to do everything. They want to take everything away from us.
Yeah, you can't suck on the teat. They're like hummingbirds, I guess you'd call them. See, the heartbeat of this thing is so fast, but he's going to die. And I'm trying to get him to go toward the feeder without hurting him. I'm just coaxing it a little bit over toward the feeder, right there. There, now stick your beak in the feeder and eat. Just, if he put his beak in the feeder, I'd feel better. Crap. All the feeders are full except for that one right there. I'm gonna take that one in the fillet. All right, little guy, I'm sorry. I'm gonna have to let you go. God, it's a mess out here, but not as big of a mess anymore now. After I wrap up my knees, I have to eventually get out here and just pick up all the little pieces all over down the yard here. Get those bigger branches down in that ditch. Sorry. I wish I could stay out here and chat, but see, this one fell off. There's a silver ring. I don't know if I'll even be able to find it over in here somewhere. It's like a thick metal ring. See, this is a major thing right here. See these things? That might have been even what stung me. I don't know. It was on the ladder. But I'm going to move this feeder and take it in the house. So clean it and put fresh food in here. And see, he's going away from the feeder now. Oh, well. Let nature take its course.